Start with Shannon again. She was just amazing. 38 again today, 23 in the third period. Talk a little bit just about her. And
she played unbelievable. It seems to be against this team. She seems to thrive. She certainly did tonight. I think she probably, quite possibly, played the game of the season tonight against Nina.
Talk about just to come up with that in the third period. I mean, we know she's capable of it, but to actually see it happen, I mean, tell me a little bit about just the, and I mean, you guys didn't really even get a shot off until the first goal there in the third period. Is it Kylie?
Kylie Anise, yes.
But just to watch Shannon do her thing there in the third period against this offense with that pressure. Talk a little bit about that.
Well, with Shannon, this is, you know, she's certainly, with a very young squad that we have, she's certainly the backbone of this team. And in situations like this, when the game is on the line in clutch situations, this is where she's at her best and where she thrives. And as you can see for yourself, you know, she's certainly the reason that the team won this game tonight.
I also wanted to ask you about what I thought was reason number two, and that was Maddie Ricci. Her job on against Jane Frieda tonight defensively, thought the empty netting goals were fitting for her. Yeah. But can you talk about what she did for you guys tonight as well?
Maddie Ricci is a little spitfire. She is just the breath of fresh air on this team. Absolutely. You know, we know that Hingham is a very tough team. Frieda's a very good player. And, you know, that was really one of her roles tonight. We knew if we had a chance to get hit against Hingham, we would have to try to shut her down. So Maddie played a huge role in doing that.
On the first goal, I mean, it looked from upstairs like I think it was Jamie who got the
Jamie
shot,
Cook.
And then but they gave it to Michaela, so I don't know. I thought Jamie shot it right through, right?
Jamie, it was, you know, we got a bit of a break. It was a 5-on-3. Jamie had a nice shot from the point. I believe there was a screen in front, so that was definitely Jamie Cook on defense.
Okay. Talk about your power play, though. I mean, the first two goals were both on power play goals. Talk
about that. That's right, and, you know, it's, I guess, the good thing, too, with Austin Prep. You know, it's such a young team. You know, on that power play, I have an eighth grader, Michaela Boyle, freshman, you know, sophomore. So it's certainly come a long way. It's something that, you know, we know that going into a tight game, a lot of times it can come down to a specialty team, such as your power play. So that's actually something we've worked on a lot as the season's progressed, and it definitely paid off for us tonight.
Talk to, if you could, first time in the playoffs for almost everybody on this team. I think the last time they made it, you know, Shannon's class were freshmen. So, you know, talk about, too, how they were able to come out. And, you know, obviously they did what they had to do to get the win tonight. And talk about that experience.
That's right. Well, it's been exciting, you know, because it's my first year with the program as well, being the head coach. And, you know, we knew that the goal that we set at the beginning of the year was simply to make the playoffs. You know, that's something that Austin hasn't been able to do for the last 3 years. And, you know, we knew going into this game, the pressure wasn't on us. You know, we wanted to come in and be the spoiler. You know, so we knew, you know, that just by simply getting the win, now we've actually achieved something that the program hasn't been able to do for 5 or 6 years, and that's advanced to the next round.
I think it's probably